Everybody. Hello, Anna.
Hi.
This is my granddaughter, Anna, and this is Anzac Ted, and I'm Veronica. And I'd like to read a story, a very special story today. Anna, have a look at all our storybooks. You like storybooks, don't you? Which is your best one? This one? The one about Anzac Ted? Look, Anzac looks the same. Hey, why does Anzac have a plaster?
Because he got the eyes.
What's wrong with the eye? Why do we wear a plaster?
Because that Anzac said he put a plaster on his eye.
Yeah? But when do you wear a plaster? When mommy put plaster on you, what's wrong? Why do we need a plaster?
Because when we were playing at school with my friend Alex, he hurt his knee.
Oh, then you get a plaster?
Yeah.
Does it make it better? Maybe that's why Teddy's wearing one, hey? Look, the story is about Anzac Ted. And what is that, Anna?
Poppy.
A poppy? Where have you seen that?
He was making a poppy.
Oh, was it that one up there?
Yeah.
That's right, and those are poppies too. Do you know what that is called? A wreath.
A wreath.
And you know, a wreath, we lay down, when people die, we put the wreath down. And that is just what the story is about. I want to turn this book around, and I'm going to show you what this book is about. If you look at the picture, you know it's going to be about Anzac Ted. If you look at that picture, what is that story about?
Kakariki.
That's right. And this one?
I don't know.
Is that Makariki?
Yeah.
Oh, and that one?
Bird.
So the story is about kiwi bird. Yeah. Let's see what's on the back
and
of the
book. Something at the back too.
Ah.
The tick.
Come on, I'm going to read this little part, and it says, Anzac Ted might look very scary, but there's more to this battle bear that meets the eye. This is the story, are you listening? About the Anzac spirit, and how through courage and loyalty and love, a child's teddy bear help to bring our soldiers home.
Mama, something is not the same.
Something is not the same?
Oh, the bow.
That's okay. Don't worry about that. Shall we leave now?
See, it's not the bow, the same. Oh, wow. A lot of hats.
There's a hat. What's that hat for?
For Anzac Teddy.
This one is for Anzac Teddy?
Yeah. And when I go on an adventure, I pick that hat too.
That's true. We
and
have
when,
a picture of you with that hat.
I want to do some activities outside, I put that hat too.
What does that hat do? That hat in particular?
Yeah. Check the people.
It protects, that's right. So Teddy wears a hat too.
Something is my favorite hat.
Which one? Why?
Because it got a shovel with it. Because and with a hat that I love to dig.
Okay. Indeed. Anzac Ted, and this story was written by Belinda Lansbury.
Somebody who's write the book. It's the author.
That's the author, that's right. That's,
and the illustrator writes the book.
And the illustrator does the pictures?
Yeah.
I think it was beautiful pictures in this book. Anzac Ted's a scary bear, and I can tell you why. He's missing bits, his tummy splits. He only has one eye. Oh dear.
Look, his other eye is broken.
His eye, other eye is broken?
His mouth is sad.
And he is sad. His fur is torn and dirty, and he hasn't any clothes. He doesn't hear with just one ear. He should have two of those. So one of the ears, he can't hear properly.
Oma, what's this one called?
That's not a word, my sweetheart. That's just a pattern.
Oh,
his head is kind of wobbly.
Wow.
And his legs are rather slow, which means he can't walk fast. Perhaps it's due to one or two encounters with foe. Anna, let's see why Teddy's like that.
Look, he's dirty. What?
You know what? Teddy went with to school. Because it was show and tell, and all the boys and girls They said, "Why is Daddy so dirty? What's wrong with him?
And why is eyes broken?"
Yeah, they asked many, many questions. And you know what? They didn't know what? That Daddy was special.
That's what?
They just didn't know how special Daddy was. Huh? They just can't see his special or the secret he may hold. He might be born in Benetton.
What's the secret in
the home? Anzac's very old.
Well, what's the
look, in a newspaper.
Oh.
Daily News. War Anzacs to aid Britain. It means the Anzac soldiers, they need to come help another country. And those, just a second, those were the soldiers that came from New Zealand and Australia.
Australia?
Uh-huh. So Anzac Day is really special, Anna.
Huh?
We celebrate Anzac Day on Saturday.
Saturday is Saturday.
What day is today, you know? The
Thursday.
And then
Friday.
And then Saturday.
Saturday.
So we have two more sleeps and then it's Anzac Day, right?
And
a really special day. So Anzac was my grandpa's, and when my grandpa was a kid, he made it through a war to just like the Anzac
Day. What are you gonna do with Anzac Day?
Oh, I have something special prepared for us. Look, you see this here?
Yeah. What are you going to put in there?
We're going to put a little light in there.
Light, a little light.
And we're going to make more poppies, okay? Would you help me make more poppies?
Yeah, no.
And then we put poppies. That in our garden.
No, we got poppies over there.
I know.
And
that means, less we forget means we mustn't forget about the soldiers who died for us.
I put a picture because it bought the pollen inside and then you draw the back.
That's right. Can I just finish my story quickly?
Oh, I don't like
it. And when Grandpa Jack enlisted, he was only 21.
21?
He kissed his wife, he loved his life, and he hugged his baby son. Grandma packed a teddy bear, the bear called his own. For luck, she said, "Take Anzac, Ted. I know he'll bring you home." So Anzac Ted went off to war from Africa to Greece.
Africa to Greece?
Greece, yes. It's
what's in Africa and Greece?
Africa is a country and Greece is a country too.
And what's in Africa and Greece? What's in there?
What's in Africa?
Yeah,
you
Greece.
Know Africa really well.
I can't. I know about
it. I have a story about Greece. Shall we read it later?
Yeah.
And in each other's tent that ends, and in each tent that ends a queen, he gave our soldiers peace. So they lived in tents over there.
Look, there's a diamond.
That's the same cross like we have on this one, yay.
It's not the same, it's going up and that's going like that.
But it means the same thing as a cross.
Yeah,
you know why they have a cross in there?
Yeah.
When people die, we always see that.
And also when they can't move.
Not quite. I want to put that down. If you're still alive, we can't do that. He soon became their mascot, and despite the diggers' dread, they knew that they would make it through alongside Anzac Ted. So Anzac Ted went along everywhere. So Anzac was a hero.
Oh, hero.
When the war was finally done, through battle sore and scarred by war, he faced his fears and won. He never wore or saw a medal. But some heroes never do. And we don't just see how we'll be without our Anzac crew.
Oh, look, long grass.
I know, darling. Looks really dry, eh?
It looks like... Whoa, what's that?
Something happened and it went...
What's that?
I don't know.
The soldiers are running.
They are running.
Why are they walking?
Because they do... they're having war, darling. Huh? Fighting. Is fighting good?
No.
No, I'm not good.
I don't want to die.
Me neither. I know he is. He isn't pretty.
Look,
I know he isn't pretty, and some people roll their eyes. But if they see like you and me, through Anzac's thin disguise,
there's more patterns.
They'll see a hero, plain as day, who sits upon my bed. A hero who saved me and you. His name is
Anzac Teddy.
The end.
Hey, what's that people? What's that people's name?
That's a soldier.
Soldier, not again.
I don't know the soldier. soldier's name, darling?
No soldier name.